Let's go to see. Hello, everyone. Let's go to see something interesting. You see here. A div outer has one H1 tag, two images, then the middle div with an image, and then the inner div. How you can style this? This the outer div. How you can style this div so that the inner divs appear smaller width than the outer div. In the style, you set that the width is 100% and text align center. The middle, you can style it as many percent you want, and the margin to be auto, so the text is placed in the center. In the inner, I have give a color red, the background color, a width 100% and the padding. And for the outer of inner, I have set a width 68%, textualized center, a margin, 0 pixel top and bottom, and auto left and right. And for the first, for the H1 tag, top 0 to appear in the, and of course, I have a onload function that is called slider. What does the slider? I have changed it. I have renamed it. If I want, I can write here. Resize. No slider. No, this is correct. This is the slider. I have two functions that swap the images. Let's run it to see what happens. This is the function resize, and this is the function slider. I will run both functions to see what happens in each one. Let's go to localhost. You see here the swapping effect that is taking place. This is the outer text. This is the middle text. You see here that the text takes place underneath the images, because I have placed, if you observe in the code, I have placed the images before the text. If I want, inside the H1, if I want, I can place the images before the H1, so the text will take place. I can make it take place beside the images. It doesn't matter for this exam. This is the middle text, and this is the outer. Let's run the resize function to see what happens. I will load the document again. Nothing happened. If I go to resize, yes, because it's image, it's image one and image two. I have to write here image one. So the get element by ID, we get the image one. I have gave an ID to the image, image one, and then this image will move across the, it will be resized and it will move across the screen. It will getting bigger and bigger until it reaches 2000 pixels, and then it will shrink to the value of 100, and then with the set timeout we'll call again this function. Let's run it to see what happens. Nothing happened. So we have document get element width is 100, so I have to take this image here and paste it out of the h1 function, out the h1 tag, in order for the program to see it. You see here that the image getting bigger and bigger, the width changes until it reaches the value of 2000 pixels. And then it will be stirring again. You see here the effect. So be careful. If you want to affect an ID of an image, you have to include it outside of the H tags. Okay. Okay. If I want, I can change this to 40%, and then you will observe that this text here, this text at the bottom, it will be string, will take 40% of the area of this area, of the div of this area. If I load again, you see here it shrinks. It shrinks as many pixels as I want to be shrink. Okay. And this is the middle text. If I want, I can make this text here to appear on this line here. I will show you how to do this. You simply go to middle div and you say, you create a paragraph and you style it and you say top 0, and you go at the end of the text and you close the paragraph. So this must do the trick. If you go here, no, it still appears on the bottom. Yes, because it has this image if I move this image, copy it and move it outside of the div, and then say that float right inside the h1 tag we observe. Ο κεραυνός θα είναι, ρε. Ναι. Αφού πες ο κεραυνός. Yes. Because this div here affects also this div here, so I have to say this. Clear both. Float right. Let's see what we have made. We have succeeded. Nothing happened. So I will style also this tag here. And you see now the inner text appears below the outer div. This is the outer text here. Again, middle text and the inner text appears on the bottom. So this text here, that is, it belongs to the inner div. The inner div. This text here appears first in the HTML document. Okay. So with this these tricks, with style, float and top, you can change the position of the text of the divs and appear the inner text first and the first last. Okay. Okay, thank you very much for watching. I hope you got the idea of how the divs works. And thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.